What makes touch loving? Embracing? Manipulative? Neglecting? Or abusive?
How do we know what a certain touch means?
Does it depend on who is touching you?
Does it feel different being touched by a man or a woman?
Does it feel different touching a man or a woman?
So are you going to get it out?
Yeah, when I want to.
Well, does it actually want to get out? I mean, does the cello actually want to be played?
Yeah, of course it does.
Are you sure you're not using it up without its permission?
Look, if the cello had hands, it would play itself. But it doesn't, so I have to get it out. I have to play it, make it sound, make it sing. The only way he can do what he's supposed to do.
He? Wait, I thought it was a she.
Does it really matter?
Well, yeah. I mean, wouldn't you play differently if it was a she? I mean, if you could choose if it was a he or a she, which one would you go for?
It's neither a he nor a she. It's just an object.
Wait, so you're telling me it's just an object, that it's passive as it is? You know, I really don't think that it is as passive as you say, because it dictates the way you play it. How it's built, how it looks, like the chairs we're sitting on, like a bench we're sitting on, like the chair you actually are sitting on. I mean, chairs are not as passive as one might think. They dictate the way you sit on them. And I think sometimes a chair needs a rest. Like right now. Right now. Not you though. You're playing something for us. And we are going to do a little warm-up together. Very simple, just follow my lead, copy my movements, you can copy my face as well if you want. Simple sidestep in the beginning. And the first movement is stop, 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 stop. And you should know a little attitude. No, no, no. Alright, watch closely.
Thank you. think it likes being treated like that.
Well, I didn't hear it complain, did I?
Have you learnt anything about it?
Well...
Fine, can you go and stand over here, please?
Arms. So we have here a rather delicate object. We start at the top, with this thick block of wood that we call the scroll. Protruding rather awkwardly on either side are a set of pegs. These can be twisted in either direction to either increase or decrease tension across the whole body. The scroll sits on top of a neck. The neck is long and slender, delicate, smooth, thin, fragile. The neck takes us down to the main body of the instrument. Observe, please, the round shoulders and the curvy hips. The strings are connected from the scroll and are drawn across the whole body. The sound that emanates in this midriff region is released through the holes on either side. Now we come to the bridge. This is the weakest, most vulnerable part of the whole instrument. I would not recommend you touch one unless you know exactly what you are doing. The spike balances the whole instrument, anchors it to the floor. But the cello could not do much on its own without the bow. That's the real instrument. You take it in your right hand. The hand drops, the shoulder sinks, the elbow releases, and the arm swings out and in. The right hand is always in charge, through a single connection from the string, through the fingers, to the back. The bow is the real instrument.